Good morning. At the beginning, I would like to present outline of my presentation. Firstly, I would like to briefly present the history of weather observation at Mount Śnieżka. Next, I would like to present climatic patterns of Mount Śnieżka. It is a really specific place with really specific climate feature. Next, I show changes in air temperature based on the long-term measurements data. And at the end, I would like to present changes in air temperature for two periods in the future. Karkonosze Mountains are located in the southwestern part of Poland and in the north of Czech Republic. It is the highest range of the Sudetes Mountains, and the main Karkonosze Ridge extends about 70 kilometers from southwest to north, southeast, excuse me, southeast to north west direction. The highest peak of the Karkonosze Mountains, it is the Mount Śnieżka with an elevation of 1,603 meters above sea level. Mount Śnieżka, it is the isolated mountain summit, as you can see on this picture, on these photos. And this area is not affected by direct human impact. On the top of the Śnieżka, there is a high mountain observatory. Now it is the first order meteorological station of the Polish National Meteorological and Hydrological Service. But this place has a really long history of weather observation. First meteorological observation began in July 1824 and took place only during the summer seasons. The observations were done for 11 seasons, and the results were published by Professor Galle in 1857. 1st of July 1880, it is the beginning of the regular continuous observations. And measuring equipment were located in the old hostel. After 20 years, in July 1900, the meteorological instruments were moved to the new building. And after more than 70 years, in October 1976, the meteorological station was moved from the old to the new building, and it has been working there until now. What is important that the relocation of measuring equipment in 1976 did not affect the homogeneity of the air temperature data series. And on this photos you can see the old building of Mountain Observatory in the summer and winter seasons. And this picture you can see old and new buildings. Now let me present some climatic features of Mount Śnieżka. Firstly, the wind patterns. This chart on the right side shows the frequency of wind direction, and this chart on the left side shows the mean speed of wind for each directions. So winds from western direction are the most common, More than 60% of winds are from northwest, west, and southwest directions. The highest wind speed are related to west direction and also northwest direction. The mean annual value of wind speed, it is 12.7 meters per second. And this highest part of Karkonosze Mountains, it is the area with the lowest sunshine duration in Poland. When we look, for example, for the data from the Jelenia Góra station, which is located in a foreland of mountains, this station has nearly 200 hours more sunshine than Śnieżka. And when we look at the annual course of monthly sunshine totals, we see that sunshine is higher at Mount Śnieżka. It is this in a winter months. Is the sunshine is higher at Śnieżka Mountains in winter months than in the station located in the foreland of the mountains. It is because in the winter time, and the top of the mountains are often above the low-lying clouds. And on this graph, you can see the course of daily annual mean temperature for the last 30 years. This line in the middle shows you the mean daily temperature for each calendar day since the beginning of January to the end of December. But this line shows the highest daily value of temperature, and this line the lowest daily temperature recorded for the last 30 years. So we can see that the highest variability, highest variation between the highest and lowest daily temperature is observed in winter months. And the snow cover can occur in the top part of Karkonosze Mountains in each month. However, usually it is more than half a year with the snow cover. But usually the first day with snow cover is noticed at the beginning of October, and the last days is usually recorded in the end of the May. However, from year to year, it's noticed a high variability of number with snow cover. And now let me summarize this part of presentation. Mean annual air temperature for last 30 years varied from 7.7 degrees in the foreland of the Karkonosze Mountains to the 1 degree at the top. The highest zone of the Karkonosze Mountains is the area with the lower sunshine duration in Poland, and Mount Śnieżka, it is an outstanding place in terms of the highest value of wind speed, according to the results of the study obtained by climatologists from the Wrocław University. Top part of the Karkonosze is characterized by the highest wind speed in the continental part of the Europe because of the length and the type of topography. One of the most commonly observed phenomena at the Mount Śnieżka, it is the fog. Mean annual number with foggy days, it is more than 300 days. Such high number of foggy days is connected with relatively and absolute altitude, as well as with exposition of the Karkonosze Mountains to the advections of wet air masses from the Atlantic Oceans. And now let me present changes in air temperature at Mount Śnieżka. This graph shows the mean annual air temperature since the 1901 to 2015. Within this period, the lowest annual mean temperature, minus 1.2 degrees, were recorded in years 1940, 1941, and 1956. But the highest value, plus 2.7 degrees, was recorded in 2014. And you can see the trend for this entire period. And this graph shows the annual air temperature anomaly as a reference period is 1961 to 1990. And this red color shows the year with the temperature above the mean for this 30 years. And we can see that since 1988, dominate years with the temperature above the mean for this reference period. And this graph shows mean temperature values for consecutive 12 months. And this approach helps identify 12-month episodes with remarkable temperature anomalies that do not coincide with a calendar year. And this approach indicates that since 1902, the warmest 12-month period has been noticed from July 2006 to June 2007, and the mean value for this period was equal to 3.3 degrees. And now let me show the course of annual minimum and maximum temperature for analyzing period, and what is important, that increase in minimum temperature is higher than increase for the maximum annual temperature. Temperature increase for all seasons. However, the strongest warming rate is observed in summer season. And in this table shows the 10-year mean annual temperature for the season and for the year. And the last decade, it is the warmest with the temperature 1.3 degrees, and also the last decade was the warmest when we calculate temperature for the spring, summer seasons. And two previous years, 2014 and 2015, were the warmest since the beginning of the 20th century. And when we look at the course of the daily mean temperature for the 2014, we can see the long period with the daily temperature above the mean value, especially since the February to April and since the September to the middle of December. But when we look at the course of the daily mean temperature for the 2015, we can see the periods with the really high positive air temperature anomaly. For example, in the November, for example, the 3rd of November, we notice mean temperature plus 14.3 degree, but mean temperature calculated based on 30 years, it is minus 0.6. And now let me present future changes in air temperature in Karkonosze Mountains. And this part of presentation is based on CLAPS project results. Within the CLAPS project, we used three scenarios, A1B, RCP 2.6 and RCP 8.5. And in CLAPS project, the following future periods have been considered: near future 2021 to 2050 and far future 2071 to 2100. And this table shows the changes in annual air temperature in Karkonosze Mountains for near and far future compared to the reference period. So we can see the slightly higher increase in annual temperature are projected for Śnieżka than for the Jelenia Góra, which is represent the foreland of the Karkonosze Mountains. It means that the summit part of Karkonosze Mountains will be more affected by temperature increase. And this table shows the changes in seasonal temperature also from the near and far future compared to the reference period. And and you can see that in near and far future, the higher warming are projected for the top mountains regions as compared to the foreland of Karkonosze. However, in winter, the spatial pattern are different under scenarios A1B and RCP 8.5. The foreland will be more affected by temperature increase than a summit zone. And the one concluding remark, the long-term uninterrupted measurements at Mount Śnieżka are a valuable source for the climate change study, especially in the mountains regions in Central Europe. And some photos from this place. This photo was by Piotr Krzaczkowski. He is the head of the our station. No, thank you.
Thank you very much, Irina, for this very interesting talk and enticing data from that specific station. The talk is now open for questions and discussion. Christian.
I have first a question that's related to the plans of the German Weather Service to reduce the amount of manned stations, so to switch towards automatized stations. Is the same plan for Śnieżko?
Now it is the measured as up to now, but in the future we don't know. Probably the number of person who work at the station will be reduced, but at the moment we don't know.
There are no plans yet.
No, just under consideration.
Okay. The second question relates to the other island stations that are relatively close to Śnieżka, which would be Fichtelberg at the site of Saxony and also the Brocken maybe, and there are eventually others that have specialties. Is there any idea to compare in the future those different stations that are always islands in the atmosphere?
Yes, I think it is really worth to compare this measurements from this place in a future research, in a future study. Yeah, but at the moment it is not done, I guess. Maybe, yeah.
Any further questions or comments? They can be in German or in English, whatever you like.
What's about Lamnitsky? Is it and more in the south, the next station, in the Polish Republic. No, what about Lamnitsky did? With personal observing or automatically?
could you ask?
No, ganz einfach.
Was ist mit der Lamnitzer-Spitze?
Station. Which station?
Lomnitsky.
It is the station in Slovakia, yes. I think.
Not in Poland.
Not in Poland, it is in Slovakia, Tatra, mountains. But we have also the other mountains station in Tatra mountains at Kasprowy Wierch. Yeah.
And any news about that station?
Yes, we have the data from the station, it is the shorter measurements period. Śnieżka has a longer period of measurements. But we also do some study to compare these measurements from these two mountains stations.